The candle flame faded dim. Lina stayed hidden until the giantess's footsteps had died away. Then she ordered the swans to wake the prince, jumped into the cot beside him, and called out. Magic cot without delay, carry us off to where I say, and she ordered it to take them to the giantess's wood. The cot soared into the air and flew until they reached a black wood. There Rinia Lini hid in the crown of the tall tree. Rinia broke off a thick branch and made himself a sturdy spear. Before long, the ogresses arrived. They sat down beneath the very tree in which the prince and the little gardener were crouching and began to throw golden eggs to each other. Prince Rinia aimed his spear carefully and smack! The golden egg was shattered to a thousand pieces, and the giantesses were turned into black crows. Without delay, Rinia and Lini ordered the cot to take them back to the cave. There, they filled their pockets with gold and precious stones. Then, they ordered the cot to take them home. What a celebration there was when they both returned safe and well. The king prepared a grand wedding for them and gave them his whole kingdom, leaving himself only the court tart. And Rinia and Lini? They have stopped quarreling. Lini sits on the throne ruling the kingdom, and Prince Rinia does all the sleeping for her in the little courtyard.